When three Big Island girls signed up for aerospace classes, they didn't realize how much they'd enjoy it.
Let alone design award-winning project for NASA. Bridget Namata introduces us to these whiz kids on the Big Island.
Have you ever designed a chair before?
Nope.
No, so this is our first time.
Meet Anja, Mikaella, and Lynelle, aerospace design students from Makua Lani Christian Academy on the Big Island.
This backrest becomes the shin rest because this chair converts to a kneeling posture chair.
They designed and built a lunar habitat chair for the NASA Hunch program, a competition where students design products that astronauts may use in space. Their winning chair is specially designed for use on the moon.
So when you're in space, for the astronauts, the reason why we created this posture chair was mainly so that their fluids can disperse more evenly, because since there is no gravity in space, it kind of ruins their like blood flow and circulation. And so that was also one of the reasons why we won this competition, was the uniqueness of our chair, because they haven't seen anyone else do a posture chair like this.
With guidance from teacher Frederick Herman, the students spent all school year working on their prototype.
It was a lot of trial and error. We did so much research. We originally thought the chair was going to be inflatable.
Yeah.
But that didn't work. There were so many things that didn't work. So honestly, something we learned is if you want to make something work and build something that works, you have to experiment a lot.
A lot of hours were put into this chair.
So we have this thing called an FNS, which is a Friday night sacrifice.
Which is basically when we all stay after school in Mr. Herman's classroom and work on the things we don't get to work on, because, you know, a class is only so long. And so we stay after school usually until 8 or 9.
Really late.
Losing all those Friday nights paid off. The girls are heading to the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, to meet with NASA and show off their lunar habitat chair. It's a big leap from when they first signed up for aerospace classes.
In the beginning, me and Lynelle originally just joined for fun because we didn't want to take a science class.
Turns out, aerospace taught them a lot about the cosmos.
We're so small. Like, I remember we were talking like perspective of like a person, or even just like the whole Earth compared to the universe.
And themselves.
Learning the importance of workspace collaboration and getting to work with people, you know, from different backgrounds with different ideas, because at the end of the day, like, everybody has something to contribute to the table.
I learned that procrastination does not take you anywhere. If you want to do something, you got to do it right now. So like for us, I think we struggled a lot with procrastinating a lot of things. But with this chair, it kind of helped us learn more about, you know, taking time and making ourselves be more wise with what we do and stuff like that.
I am really proud of them. What I like about them is their imaginations. I would put it this way. An engineer once told me that it's better to work with young people, because when you work with young people, they don't know yet what they can't do. And so they assume they can do anything. And so you get this better idea pool. They come up with these crazy ideas and these random ideas.
I feel like we always see boys kind of taking on that kind of stuff. And it can be discouraging because that's all you see. Mm-hmm. And it's like stereotypical, like you can't do that stuff. But we did, and we were very successful.
In Kona, Bridget Namata, KHON2 News, working for Hawaii.
One small chair for man, one giant leap for womankind.
I just love that with all my heart, every single part of it. And I love that, you know, they sacrifice their Friday nights, but that's a great social activity to get together and ingenuity, and it's just amazing.
And young ladies in engineering, it's fantastic.
It's great.
Well,